This video has provided a supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to show how to find holes in a rational function. So let's say we've got a rational function like this one. F of x equals x plus 2 over x squared minus x minus 6. And we want to graph this. Now, normally when we deal with a rational function, we want to make sure it's factored as much as it can be. The numerator is going to stay the same. That x plus 2 can't be factored anymore. But we can factor the denominator. So we're going to have x plus 2 over x minus 3 times x plus 2. Now, when we look at this factored form, we realize we've got the same factor in the numerator and the denominator. That's this x plus 2. When we've got a common factor in both the numerator and the denominator, that means we're going to have a hole in the function. The hole is going to occur at the place where that common factor, in this case the x plus 2, would equal 0. So x plus 2 equals 0 when x equals negative 2. So now we know the x coordinate for the hole we want. That's going to be at x equals negative 2. So we're going to have a hole at negative 2, comma, something. The something is the y-coordinate for that location. So here's how we're going to find the y-coordinate. We'll factor out that x plus 2. We'll divide both the numerator and the denominator by x plus 2. Now all I've got is 1 over x minus 3. And I want to find out what the y-value is. So what I'm going to do is take this 1 over x minus 3 and replace the x with that negative 2. So I'll have 1 over negative 2 minus 3. So negative 2 minus 3 is negative 5. I've got 1 over negative 5, which is the same as negative 1/5. So my hole is going to occur at negative 2, comma, negative 1/5. And now I can sketch the graph. One of the factors, or the remaining factor, that I have in my rational function is x minus 3, which means I'm going to have a vertical asymptote at x equals 3. So I'll just put in a dotted line along here where x equals 3. My horizontal asymptote is going to be at y equals 0. So I can start sketching the graph in. I'll start just below that horizontal asymptote and curve downwards towards the vertical asymptote. And then I'll start up again at the top of the vertical asymptote and curve downwards and to the right on the horizontal asymptote. Okay, now, before I finish, I have to show the location where the hole is. The hole was at negative 2, comma, negative 1/5. So at that point on the graph, what I want to do is draw a small circle to show that the graph does not continue at that point. There's a hole at that point. And I should also label that point negative 2, comma, negative 1/5. Okay, so that's basically what we're going to do. We're going to factor the whole thing out, see if there are any common factors. If there's a common factor, that tells us there's going to be a hole in the graph. The hole will occur where the common factor at the x value that makes the common factor equal to 0. In this case, it was x equals negative 2. Once we know the x coordinate for that hole, we use that coordinate to find the y coordinate. That was that negative 1/5. Then we sketch in the graph, draw a small circle where the hole is, label the circle, and we're done. Okay? Take care. I'll see you next time.